What if we have been looking at the universe incorrectly? What would it mean if all our observations of the universe were based on a fundamental understanding that was misinterpreted and falsely calculated? What if the universe wasn't actually expanding? Is it all just in our heads? Back in the 1920s, two side-by-side developments occurred that paved the way for our modern understanding of the universe. On the theoretical side, we were able to derive that if you obeyed the laws of general relativity and had a universe that was, on average, uniformly filled with matter and energy, your universe couldn't be static and stable, but must either expand or collapse. On the observational side, we began to identify galaxies beyond the Milky Way and quickly determined that, on average, the farther away they were observed to be, the faster they were observed to be receding from us. Simply by putting theory and observation together, the notion of the expanding universe was born and has been with us ever since. Our standard model of cosmology, including the Big Bang, cosmic inflation, the formation of cosmic structure and dark matter and dark energy, is all built upon the basic foundation of the expanding universe. But have we calculated this basic foundation incorrectly? Is this an assumption that we've made early on that's actually wrong? Is the expanding universe an absolute necessity in our understanding of physics? Or is there a way around it? In a controversial new paper, theoretical physicist Lucas Lombriser argues that the expanding universe can be transformed away by manipulating the equations of general relativity. In his scenario, the observed cosmic expansion would merely be an illusion, a mirage, a false assumption. But does this stand up to the science we already know? Let's investigate. It might seem like a frivolous choice to make, but oftentimes in science, just by changing the way we look at a problem, we can uncover some features about it that were obscure in the old perspective, but become clear in the new one. It makes us wonder, and this is what Lombriser explored in his new paper, just what we'd conclude about some of the biggest puzzles of all if we adopted this alternative perspective. So instead of the standard way of viewing cosmology, we can instead formulate your universe as static and non-expanding at the expense of having masses, lengths, and time scales all change and evolve. First, we reformulate how structure grows in the universe. Normally, in the standard picture, we start out with a slightly overdense region of space, where the density in this region is just slightly above the cosmic mean. Then, over time, this gravitational perturbation preferentially attracts more matter to it than the surrounding regions, causing space in that region to expand more slowly than the cosmic average, and as the density grows, it eventually crosses a critical threshold, triggering conditions where it's gravitationally bound, and then it begins gravitationally contracting, where it grows into a piece of cosmic structure, like a star cluster, galaxy, or even larger collection of galaxies. If you take this approach, however unpalatable it may seem, we are able to reinterpret some of the presently inexplicable properties our universe seems to possess. For example, there's the cosmological constant problem, where for some reason, the universe behaves as though it were filled with a field of constant energy density inherent to space, an energy density that doesn't dilute or change in value as the universe expands. This wasn't important long ago, but appears to be important now, only because the matter density has diluted below a certain critical threshold. We don't know why space should have this non-zero energy density, or why it should take on the value that's consistent with our observed dark energy. In the standard picture, it's just an unexplained mystery. However, in this reformulated approach, there's a relationship between the value of the cosmological constant and, if you have mass scales and distance scales changing according to the new formulation, the inverse of the Planck length squared. Sure, the Planck length changes as the universe evolves in this new formulation, but it evolves biased toward the observer. The value we observe now has the value that it has now simply because it is now. If times, masses, and lengths all evolve together, then that eliminates what we call the coincidence problem in cosmology. Any observer will observe their effective cosmological constant to be important now because their now keeps evolving with cosmic time. This is a remarkable feature about our universe under the standard way of looking at things. The very same laws of physics that apply here on Earth apply everywhere else in the universe at all locations and times throughout our cosmic history, which means we need to test if the alternative to the expanding universe successfully describes the larger universe and also applies on Earth based on every previous assumption about dark matter and dark energy that we have made. So what do we do now? We keep playing in the sandbox and exploring alternatives to the standard cosmological and particle physics pictures of reality, and we see if we need to restructure our understanding of our universe. And we enjoy where science takes us, deeper into our current knowledge or towards a different future. Thank you for watching Oberon Labs, and subscribe to expand your mind one universe at a time.